What's up, y'all? So me and Miss Lana are playing at the Rockstar Cafe, and this is our first time doing a collab at a review. And so she's been coming here for the original one for 5 years?
7.5 years now.
Boom. So I'm gonna let her just take over, and I'm just gonna enjoy it, so go ahead.
All right. So I just want to remind you all to spread a little love and sprinkle share on that button. Sharing is caring, and that's what it's all about. And we're gonna share some information here. Rockstar Cafe here in now in Oldsmar, Florida, started out over in Palm Harbor, and I started coming here as a result of I literally found them within the first couple weeks of when they opened the restaurant, and I knew I had to adjust my eating because of all of the health issues that I was experiencing in my life. I found out I was allergic to gluten. I didn't want to give up. I didn't choose to give up my filet mignon, my real butter. It just kind of evolved, and it was beautiful because it was like all of a sudden I had an alternative without looking for it. It just arrived in my face, and it was like, oh my gosh. And I instantly connected with Karen and Adam. They're an amazing couple. They both from Boston. I'm from Boston, so of course, you know, a little Boston accent going on and having a little attitude and catching up and all that. And so we both agreed. We were talking about how much we were foodies, and that's how we really connected, was like, oh, it's all about the food. And we even shared some of our old stories about how much we used to eat and all those yummy nastiness that we would get on. Whoop, what? So I was really excited to be able to come over here today with Tom because he's never been here. And this is obviously, for me, it's my favorite place to come. And it's one of the first places I'd ever been to that was a raw vegan restaurant where I didn't have to worry about the gluten contamination. I didn't have to worry about soy or dairy or processed foods. Everything is made in-house with love from their hearts. And I'm telling you, that's one of the most important things, that when you go to a restaurant, most people don't take into consideration whether or not the food is infused with yummy goodness from the heart, right? I know you want to say something.
Well, let's do this. Where they're located, both locations?
No, it's just here right now.
That's it?
Yeah.
So the original ones no longer exist?
No, they moved over here to get a bigger
okay.
space.
Okay, so here's the organic raw vegan creations. Check it out. Check out the menu. Look at that. I think they nailed it. And I haven't eaten here yet, but it's pretty simple. They've got it laid out, you know, and then they've got the smoothies on the back. Look at that. And then I'll show you this. They've got specialty smoothies. These are the Rockstar Cafe specialty smoothies. And they've got 7 of these, 8 of these. And look at these. Oh, they got some more on the back too. So there's about 12 of these, right? Strawberry protein smoothie. Tastes like key lime smoothie.
Yum.
Tropical smoothie. And very, very rad prices, y'all. I would even say I haven't tried it yet, but I've been kicking around some ideas, just playful. And you know, like when I make a smoothie, or when I see these type of smoothies, I always think they should be like $8 to $10. So very decent price. They're all under $8.
And he had a sample of two of them already.
And they're delicious, delicious. And they have little tasters, and she let me, Rhea, I think it was, that I figured out.
Rhea.
Yeah.
I
think it's R-E-I or I-E-A, one of those. Well, she gave me 4 little testers, and they have like a nacho cheese, a bean dip one, or the other two.
The Rockstar.
Rockstar, which was really, really good. And then there was a fourth
Eggless.
One too. Right, right.
Oh, chili.
They had an egg salad one.
Eggless.
So this is right here.
These are the sauces that go with the dishes in front of us. So this right here is the nacho cheese. That's ours. Nacho cheese ours. And this is the mustard dressing. And they're both delicious. So I always ask for more of both.
Okay, so let's start with the dish.
So here is the burger, the raw burger platter. And there's a dehydrated onion rings in here. The burger itself is a mix of a bunch of nuts and seeds and flax. This is the slaw, which is, oh my God, with that sauce. And I like to take a little bit of the slaw, put it on top of the burger and make it, it's got a flax seed, a very thin
layer. You've had this one before, man?
Oh my God, yeah. That's one of my favorites.
Look at that.
Look at that. Real food. Right. Living food, whole food, plant-based.
So let's go over all the dishes and then we'll dive into one at a time. So okay. Which one's this?
So this is the Rawrito. Not a burrito, but a Rawrito. It's not
check
on here.
Oh, it's not on here. Check that out.
And so I forgot. What's the pate in the Rawrito again? The rocks. Oh, I thought that was in the Rocco roll. This is the bean one?
Sunflower seeds is beans, y'all.
It's a great alternative. You know baboofas? It reduced the baboofas because it's not beany.
Okay. How fun is this?
Right? It's super yum, right?
Right. And y'all have any digestive issues? Eat real food. Rockstar real food.
Big time.
That's the next one.
And so this one is the Rocco roll, which is my favorite of the two.
Look
and
at
this,
that.
I had them put some sprouts in it. And again, this is the Rockstar pate. And in the Rockstar pate, there is the, let's see real quick. It's pecans, pumpkin seeds, apple, red bell pepper, and Mediterranean herbs and spices.
Look at that thumb action. Get some of that thumb action. What? Okay, then we have one more.
And this was one of my first all-time favorites when I first started coming here to when they were at the other location. This is the Avo DLT.
Ooh, Avo DLT?
It's apple smoked dulse.
Okay, this is already gonna be my favorite. Look at this.
You can have a bigger half of it.
Check out that thumb action, y'all. Get up in there. Look, real food does have smells too that I'm learning. Raw food does smell. You don't need all those carcinogens and all that other stuff, right? Look at, get a whiff of that. Look at that thumb action. Mm-hmm. Okay, so which one do you want to try first?
This is Rockstar Cafe, Nikki. It's here in Florida. They're originally from Boston too, by the way. They started this restaurant, and I always take my rings off because this gets finger licking good. We also have these cabbage crackers, which are super yummy as well. They're right here, forks and, oh, he's also got some other goodies he's picked up.
Oh, I'm gonna show this one too.
Oh, and the bottle? They have a green one too.
Check these out, y'all. Look at this rad color, right? So this is good. This is like a hydrating bottle, right? She can put her kombuchas in there. I'm gonna use this as my lemon water bottle. And look at the texture on that, and it's glass, right? And then they have a whole bunch of rad fun little toys here. This one is exotic jackfruit. Exotic jackfruit. So it's all organic and all wild crafted, raw and vegan. You get 5 ounces for about $6. And check these out. I haven't tasted them yet, but I'll do a review soon. And so here's their address, y'all. 4011 Tampa Bay Road. And you can check out all their stuff at rockstarcafe.com. Phone number is 813-855-0007. Check it out. And I can't wait for these. And they have a whole bunch of like little toy boxes full of this cool stuff. Okay, so which one are we gonna try?
We're gonna go for the lightest of them all. We're gonna go for the Avo DLT. And I'm just giving you the big slice because I already know you need.
Okay, so do we sauce it up?
And so I've been intermittent fasted all morning. This is first meal of the day.
I just got a tomato on her purse. I better get that or she.
Mini heart attack.
Check that out. Okay.
Y'all see us eating in the kitchens and stuff, but now you get to see us in a restaurant. For the first time. I know you got that sauce.
Whoa!
Right? That avocado.
This is lights out, y'all. Wow. How did they get that bacon flavor in there?
Apple smoked dollar.
What did you just say? What did you? Apple what?
Now you get to see how we eat and speak.
When did you say apple what?
apple smoked dulse.
Apple smoked dulse is a secret weapon. For real, I never had that. Apple soaked dulse.
Smoked. It's
smoked. Right, so it's good. Well, what do they smoke it with?
Apple chips.
Yeah? And then the dulse adds the salty bacon taste too, right? Wow, this is brilliant.
Nom nom nom.
This is so good. This is so good.
You
oh my
god.
Oh yeah. Guatemalte. I made up that word and I have no idea what it means, but it's really fun to do. When you taste something good, you gotta grab your lips, you gotta go. Guatemalte. You know what? You don't need anything else with this.
Now you know why it's my favorite.
Is this a collard green? That adds a texture of like toast. Because it's crunchy.
OM yum.
Oh wait, so you ate one half and I ate the half? It's filling too, huh? I just ninja chopped your knee, sorry about that. Did that hurt? There's so much going on. Hashtag mouth pleasure, y'all.
Wet Wednesday. Now you gotta try a cracker. Cabbage crackers.
These are cabbage crackers. How about, why don't we call it a chip?
They call them crackers, but go for it.
Is this a cracker or a chip, y'all? What would you say? Looks like a rockin' rock star Dorito to me. Right. So, what do they think they do? What do they think? How do they make these?
Dehydrate.
I know, but do you think they save over a lot of stuff from prep and they just put it all together? Like this.
They actually make them and chop them.
Yeah, pinky it out on the rockin' Doritos. Well, we can't call them Doritos. We gotta call them rockin' rock star crackers. We're gonna call these star crackers.
Star crackers.
Look at the texture of that.
It's a tree.
No, they're star crackers. Boy, yours is gone. No? Definitely has a really good crunch. They don't fall apart at all, right? And they're really wholesome. You know what I mean? Like, there's no air up in these. This is like, ooh, let's dip it. You wanna dip it?
You try it.
Look, this is the cheese, right?
You may be getting more of this, by the way.
Look.
Once he tries that, there's no turning back, you watch. Right? We might need more.
Honey, but we would have to pay for it. This is the third time. They don't give it for extra for free, do they?
I'm teasing.
Oh.
Because that's meant for this. No. Not for the chips. Just saying.
Hey, could you just order some...
Those are too dry for them, so I like to dig into everything.
Can you just order the crackers, you think?
Mm-hmm.
Come here
and get... Yeah, it's on the menu.
Oh, you can just say, hey, I want a plate of crackers.
Cabbage crackers.
Oh, okay. For $5.57 for the crackers. But how many do you get?
I don't remember. How many crackers do you get in the cabbage crackers? Shelly.
She's listening. It's okay. She can hear us.
How many crackers do you get in the crackers when you order them as a... 3 ounces.
Do people buy them a lot? These are legit.
Yeah, I don't know, I've never bought them separately. Yeah.
Mm. This is like the movie theater cheese, but way better. You know, in the thing?
Yeah.
And they're hot, this is way better. And everything when you eat real whole foods is super, super filling. That's why you don't overeat. You just stop eating when you're done, right?
Because you feel it.
Yeah, because you feel it. You know what I mean? So you're not overeating with all that other yummy nastiness. For me, you just keep eating and eating and eating because the the flavor additives and the addictive stuff, and so you're not getting any calories or not getting any vitamins and minerals and stuff, so you just keep eating. Like, to
your
be honest,
your body feels satiated quicker.
That was already filling. You know what I'm saying?
I hate to see this.
She was like, "We need some more cheese." What was like
cheese? You wait.
We need some cheese.
You wait. So, I think it's time to move to the next level.
Okay, we're going to the next level. All right. So, should we? Oh, that's good. Now
we're gonna do the burger next.
Sorry, sir. I don't like to interrupt Miss Lana. But if you all, I dislike when people say guys, because there's a lot of women here. If you all like these type of videos, let us know, and we will do these a lot, okay? But we want to get some feedback on what type of content you all like, because we like to spread the love. So if you're picking up what we're laying down, and you're having a lot of fun, do a love spin boom and let us know in the comment section, okay? Buonamores.
Buonissimo.
Carry on, Miss Lana. Sorry.
So now, you're okay, still. He knows I love him, even if he interrupts me a million and one times. This is the burger platter. Hey, Carl. I love it. Feedback from Anna. Do it a lot. Okay. So, again, we have this beautiful burger. The burgers are made with sunflower seeds, shiitake, cabbage, carrots and zucchini, served between dehydrated flat breads.
Yeah.
Made with sunflower seeds, flax seeds, black sesame seeds, coconut. And then it's topped with a tahini, mustard sauce, lettuce sliced, tomato, cucumber, dehydrated onion, with a slide of slaw. Now.
That thumb action. Look at that thumb action.
Do you want This is gonna be fun. Which would you like better? This one or that one? Because I don't really want the big.
They really look, I gotta show it one more time, because if you guys really look, this looks like a hamburger with mustard and an onion. Look, doesn't that look like a patty? Right? I'll take this one. This one. But I'll have that one if you want this one.
I'll take the smaller one.
See, hold on. We gotta have a conversation.
Okay.
Do you see how she asked me which one I wanted? But she really didn't state her truth because she really knew which one she wanted. So for me, it's all about, look, I want that one, okay? I might give you this one, but I want to let you know up front, I want that one.
Or maybe, here's what I really think I did, because this is what I was doing. I really think he wanted the bigger one, but he really just wanted to give me the other one. And we both did one of these. And so in reality, he's getting what he wanted, and I'm getting what I wanted.
I'm not even listening to whatever she says.
He's doing la 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 la.
It's called selective hearing.
Here's what I like to do. I take the slaw, and I put it on my burger. This is what makes it that much more flavorful and crunchy, and what is he gonna say?
I'm not saying anything, I'm listening.
But he's thinking something.
So you put your slaw up all on it? Have you already tasted it before the slaw in the past?
Try it. You do what you like, because it's your experience.
And it's got a rad wrap underneath this thing.
Actually, you put the top on it first, because the whole thing goes together here.
Are they dehydrating that onion? This is unbelievable.
Sorry, honey.
I'm talking, she's like. Like I'm supposed to know like what all that means.
You are.
No, that is so good, y'all. I love hamburgers, and I love all that stuff, and I haven't eaten that in a very, very long time. This is better. Way better. And then we have the little rad condiments, right? This is the top.
Wait, that's my top.
They give you the top. So this is like the top bun. With the condiments, right? Look. See, look at that thumb action. Oh, yeah. Look, tomato. We got some greens. And we got some cucumber and a little patty. What? And you're supposed to just... And then the slaw, right? So you make it... put the slaw
on. You construct it first, then you eat it.
There's a slaw. The slaw dog.
Do you want a little bit more of that sauce? This is the mustard dressing, right?
I love this lifestyle. It's like being reborn.
And it's like a smorgasbord of options and new experiences that are so much more vibrant. Tastes great, less filling.
Do you think there's this stuff?
I love
having
shared experience.
Do you think there's apple cider vinegar in that slaw?
I know there is.
That you could tell, huh? So we slaw up on the bottom patty. Right? And then we ninja flip.
Wait, before you ninja flip, we gotta have the saucy sauce.
Saucy sauce. Well, now I'm not gonna be able to pick it up, right?
Yeah, you are. You're just gonna.
So this is a cheese. Now that turned it into a cheese raw burger.
This is the mustard dressing.
Oh.
The cheese is way away from me, and I'm about to reach over for it, but that's okay.
Can I?
Yeah, of course. You're talking to someone who licks everything. You know you can lick it.
See, now this doesn't taste like mustard to me. It tastes better than a mustard. It's way more smoother and silker.
It's a tahini mustard.
Okay, so, wow.
Wait, you gotta breathe in all this goodie, all this yumminess.
What?
I have to take these breaks in between to breathe because it's so delicious.
Wait a second. So, hold on.
That's his constructed burger.
Which one's mine? That one?
The furthest way away from you. And then that's mine.
Right? Delicious. Okay, here we go. This is popping my cherry. What? She's breathing. Hey, open up your lungs. Open up that life force prana. Hiya.
So these are the moments I can admit I'm having a little anxiety, tension in my breath, and that's why I don't want to eat my food immediately, because if I do, it will be kind of like with an anxiety. But it's actually that I'm so excited to share this experience that, you know, the pendulum swinging from anxiety to excitement, you know, there's these same levels. Because there's so many elements and external factors that can enter my sphere. Isn't that yummy? See, he's already devoured his. Now I'm going to go in for mine. I'm going in. Mangia, mangia, deve mangiare con amore e passione. Del cibo, del burger. Mm. Hey, Laura, how are you, honey?
For all of you that have cookouts, for like Veterans Day or 4th of July, Memorial Day, birthdays. Try to embrace this lifestyle and serve yourself this, prepare yourself this, and your family and friends. It's changing my life. I'm telling you. I get my cherry popped all day, every day. And I'm celibate. So do you feel better that you breathed? Was it the anxiety or the happiness? So if you would have just digged into it, what would it, hot flash or something? Or just digestion?
I wouldn't get the full sensual experience of the food and the flavors.
Oh, shit.
Take it slow.
I was supposed to get sensual. Yeah. Well, that was a quickie for me then. Huh.
Well, the sensuality within food. I love that he's doing this, because when he's done, if there's anything left, you know I'm going to lick the plate. But I'm okay with that.
Hi, Nia.
The thing is, for me, I have to remind myself to slow down. And when I get that, when I can't get a full breath, that's when I know I need to breathe the most and take it slower and eat my food and be present in the moment. Because then I lose the experience, and the flavors change the more you chew, the slower. I talked about this morning in my live video. This sensually and slow. And I'm gonna feed it to him too. You and Buddy, my fingers.
Baby. This tastes different than mine.
Sensual love.
Did we have the same thing? The same sauce? I think mine had more onion on it.
Yeah, I did. Remember
did
I
it?
Told you I could eat the big one?
Oh.
You got the big one.
I got the big one. So that plate's definitely lickable. Wow, see, like, for real, it's really hard to overeat with this type of stuff, but we have more entrees that we're going to do, and I'm not going to run today because this is definitely hashtag mouth pleasure, and this is a treat for sure.
Oh my, yummy. That's meant for the wraps.
Oh, these?
Yeah. He's still learning. It's okay.
Here, y'all.
I'll give it
to
you.
That is
though.
So good. You know that Frito-Lay stuff?
Here. I'm impressed.
If you all would have saw her eyes right now, she literally eyeballed the entire plate. It was like, should I lick it? Should I lick it? Should I not? Like, she zoned in the whole thing and just Lana scanned it like, like something just like was about ready. She turned into a whole new being when I gave her, when she looked at that plate. She was like this. What? I've never seen that one yet. Another cherry pop.
I've never had anybody able to read my face the way that he does.
She went in the zone, the Rock and Lana zone.
You really did see that.
Yeah, I did. Okay, we gotta keep it going. Now you don't have to, because I know you probably can't compete, can you? Okay. So So what do we got? Which one is this? This one? This. She legend. Tell them what this one is again.
That's the raw burrito.
The raw burrito. And it has, you know what? Let's slow it down this time because my tummy's full anyways. Hey, give us a lot of hearts if you can hear us pretty well because I know there's some rad music in the background. Show me the raw burrito.
It's not on there.
It's not on there. This is a special.
It's one that's up on the board. It doesn't have actually this written board where the
board. Oh yeah. A bullet cappuccino. They have really red chocolates in here too. I'm gonna buy one. Like, this is like the Disneyland of rock and food, like Orlando's right over here. You don't need to, can you imagine what kind of food you would get at Disney World? And it'd be like $100, like a soda, a burrito, two burgers, you know, a little ice cream cone. And it's, well, in our opinion, it's nasty. And that's really not that healthy. And you can come here and our bill will probably be like $7.77. And we just ate a lot, but I could have been good with just, I mean, I really did want that hamburger on top. So to come here, it'd probably be $20. Good to go, like way good to go. Ninja flip outside, go play with yourself, go play with the sun, and have fun. And until you experience it, like if you first eat it, you might actually get sick. You might even be like, I can't taste this. It's like, what is this? You know what I mean? But you keep going. But you just keep going, keep going, and raising that vibe. And this stuff is just, I mean, this is like Disneyland to me, or Disney World. And you know, if you all really like this stuff, what I mean, we're gonna continue to do anyways, just try to find places like this. And this is what I get amped up for. You know, this is what I get psyched for, you know, to get my cherry pop left and right, and try everybody's, because you know, I can tell there's a lot of love that goes into this food. I mean, you can tell that your food is handled with love, right? And you're getting the freshest produce. You know, it's just, it's life changing, you know? So.
So, do you want one in the beach? Honey, would you like one of mine?
Which one's, this is?
This is, I have the raw burrito, which has the Rockstar pate on it.
Gotta give them the thumb action. They like the thumb action.
You're good with the thumbs, honey.
Yeah. Check it out. Yeah. What? Okay. She's got the sprouts. Okay. So
would
cheese
you like
it.
One of these? Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, cheese so it up. Give me your little one, because if you can't finish anything, I will finish it. Don't underestimate my belly.
So I'm gonna go no cheese first. Sprout, upright, carrots, one more. Look at that. What? I really like sprouts too.
I'm a sproutaholic. It's a pain in the butt to sprout.
Now remember when we sprouted those mung beans and it had a similar taste? Very similar taste.
The nutty. Going in. I want probably yours first. I like the last thing that I like to be the last flavor on my tongue. Personally. That's the way I eat.
What's that then?
I like my favorite flavor to be the last flavor I touch on my tongue.
For real?
Yeah.
So like if that's avocado and that's your favorite, you would eat this and then lick that? Rather than just ninja lick it now?
It depends though. Like, I love this so much, I want that to be my last flavor.
That's cool. That's treating yourself right, right? That's giving you what you want.
Yes! It's fun to watch his experience, isn't it? Can I try your burrito-y thing? Mm-hmm. This is going to be burrito-y thing. I know how messy I am. It's all good.
This is Michael Jackson, y'all.
There's actually cheese in these. It's just...
When you go out, don't worry what anybody thinks of you. If you want to dance, dance. It doesn't matter. I used to be so scared in school. People are looking at me. Especially when you go to school really high or on a bunch of LSD. I just put my head like this.
Don't be scared. Don't be scared.
And then I would really not want anybody to call me to read, because I couldn't read all that well. Terrified armpits being like flared out. Like, don't call me, don't call me. But that's why I like to read the testimonials. These are fun. And plus they're making me read about like, not rad stuff. Who wants to read not rad stuff? I ain't got time for that. Right?
We all know y'all bring your phones to the toilet.
Yeah.
Here's
another thing. Every morning when you wake up, you're going to see a little poop emoji that says good morning with my little poop emoji. And I'm going to encourage you to step out of your box, take that deep breath, prana, and then you flip into the group and introduce yourself. So every morning while you're dropping that delicious deuce with your phone, because we all do it, you're gonna see me come across your feet in a very humorous, loving way, right? And you're gonna read one of our Rad Stars testimonials. So get used to it, right? Oh, and here's another thing. So when I first started this about a year ago, you know, most of my family unfriended me and I had to talk to them and friends, but one of my friends that did that and said that she didn't understand what I was doing, I was making her feel uncomfortable, which maybe a lot of you have. She said, I just can't watch you, you're disrespectful, or whatever this is, she said. She unfriended me. Well, yesterday, I get a friend request from her, right? And so I'm not gonna instantly, you know, accept a friend request, I'm gonna sit with it and realize whatever it was that she thought I was doing possibly was inside of her, and now she wants to play again. So, you know, when you change your life, when you do a healthy lifestyle like this, any type of change, if people aren't comfortable with it, it's more likely it's probably
inside
of them, right? So you just keep being your ridiculously authentic self and just keep doing you, because no one can take that self-love away from you. No one. When I tell you it's a superpower, people can take all they want from you, but they can't take your self-love. And so if people want to, you know, distance themselves from you, you can love them from afar. And if you want, you can have arms wide open when they come back, and you can welcome them back.
Remember, the three fingers pointing back when you're pointing a finger at someone else. You gotta make sure there's nacho cheese on this too, because the nacho cheese is coming back at you.
So I'm gonna just eat this one. Actually, I think we're done. Are we done? You wanna continue on?
We can if you'd like. Does anybody have any questions for us?
Well, I can't.
I can. No, I'll ask. I'll end.
Laura, laugh out loud. Unity poops. Whoops. Laugh out loud. Unity poops for OMG to funny. I don't know what that is.
She's laughing about the idea because we were talking about every morning you're gonna wake up.
And do those emoji poop
icons. Those toilet testimonials.
Like, you're not gonna get everybody's flavor.
God, I hope not.
You just have to choose, you know, if they have one of your flavors that they like, if it's worth playing with them and try to accept them for who they are. I'm just kidding.
Enjoy, baby. It's so yummy.
Thumb action. Well, but this is, you were right on this. You were totally right on this. We need a whole plate of this. Right, if we had a whole plate, we'd just go like this. Right? And then we could lick it. Yeah, can we make this? Just like this. She's gonna be like, mine's gonna be better.
Well, you had my cheesy sauce the other
well,
day.
I will say something real quick. Everything that I have tried from this Lana has been lights out. It's been cherry popping all day, every day. Everything. She really puts, I mean, she's really like a sensei in the kitchen. And it's fun, and it's I'm really grateful, you know, because when your senses are high, you get to play with food, and your sensei hands you like a new shiny thing of nunchucks, right? Or like a brand new Chinese star, right? Like a kombucha, or this coconut yogurt, or, you know, oatmeal, or, I mean, anything and everything that she makes. I mean, everything is just next level, and I feel like I've never even eaten good food before, you know? I mean, my food is good, but like, I just kind of whip it together, you know, for me. But I am still gonna cook you that, make you that dish, that dragon fruit, or what was it? Jackfruit, with this little thing that I'm gonna do.
The onions.
But, I mean, y'all, so food is so important, right, for everything. And when you're fueling yourself with like, or if someone's helping you feed yourself with like awesome rad food, and it's like made with love, care, and tender. If you have somebody like that, be extremely grateful and give them a ninja high five, because it can change your life.
Thank you everyone for the love, I appreciate it. And it's fun because I get to have that experience of him experiencing it. For me, that's my receiving.
This is like Taco Bell, but in heaven. This is like a Taco Bell burrito, but like, way up here. This is so good. It has like the bean dip.
Which is made with the sunflower seed, she said.
It's so good. I'm gonna tell you a quick story. So when I was a little alley rat, I never had any money, right? And we'd walk everywhere. I'd walk miles and miles and miles. And everybody would have some money. You know, and they'd go to Taco Bell and they'd get like a 7-layer burrito or whatever. Well, I was the kid that had to say I was gonna get water, and I would go get a soda, and I had no money, so I would literally get 10 packets of hot sauce, and that would be my meal when I came home. Because like sometimes my dad, that just sometimes, and I would just have, so I'd have a water and 10 little Taco Bell hot sauces, and that would be my meal. So this reminds me of that. Isn't that strange? Ooh, but then, there's another layer in here that had a little bit of sweetness into it. That's strange. There's something in there that was a little sweeter than that first bite.
They even get it squished the other way to get the mix of the fruit, the vegetables. My job is too. I've never had it with the sprouts. I like it without, but I love the sprouts.
Well,
the sprouts are delicious, but without it, it's so yummy. All
right, so check it out. You've been here before. What is your favorite dish out of everything we've had? Isn't that hard?
It is hard. That's what I was saying. The avocado DLT is definitely my favorite. Because we've already agreed. Right? So I was saying earlier today, we were talking about our shopping list, and I said, well, we know we need to triple up on anything the two of us likes, because we want to make sure we have some left if we need it. Because we know what we both mutually enjoy and love. And that's dates, almond butter, and avocados.
Bananas. All day, every day.
Yep. So we're over here.
Hi. Good.
Do you want to introduce? This is Adam. He's one of the founders of this beautiful establishment.
Thank you so much for this amazing food.
This is Tom.
We're on Facebook Live. Would you like to say hello? We're doing a review.
Sure.
Introduce yourself. Come sit down.
This is our ridiculously authentic group on Facebook. This is Adam.
Hello. How are you?
And he's going to give you a little Boston-esque accent.
No. I got my car parked over there. I just pulled in from the parking lot. I just went and got some organic vegetables for you all for the kitchen.
So
come on
by. You know why we came by today?
Some.
Those chicken nuggets with the jicama fries.
Just, tomorrow we're making more right now.
We're going to have to make an order and then we'll come
fries
back.
Jicama fries and nuggets, they're delicious. Come on by. I like the floating hots.
You're getting a very handsome, they're all saying hi to you.
Thank you, thank you.
If you're here in Oldsmar or ever find yourself in this area, you have to stop in here. This place is the bomb diggity. I've been coming here since they opened.
They're like family to me.
Come on by, we're forward to seeing you. We pack out front. Thanks. All right, bye.
Nice meeting you,
guys. Thank you.
All over the place.
Yeah.
All over. I was born in Phoenix, but I've been traveling for quite some time.
Most I made it was to Sedona.
Oh, okay. That's nice, nice there.
Yeah,
we're having
nice.
Funky hair awesome. Now.
So the jicama fries and the nuggets must have been amazing because you sold out.
I might still have some. I don't know about the fries. Yeah. I'll see if I have any more fries.
Do you guys do that every day?
Today was the first day ever.
Well, yeah, it was a success.
Yes, right? Yeah, it was a success.
I saw so that on Facebook and I said, we have to go try that.
Yeah, and we're going to do them again tomorrow and then we're going to pop something new.
We might have to come back to try that.
I already said two of them. Cool. We'll probably put in an order and just come and pick it up.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. Let me know for sure and I will make sure we keep these
We'll Thank definitely you let you know before.
An awesome place. For real.
Let
right?
us know if you do have yeah. something snuck back there to try. We love samples. Oh, thank you so much, Jeanette. So this isn't very far from you, technically. Oh, thank you. I got this at Disneyland, believe Disney World at Epcot Center.
So you think the ALT was the best?
GLT for sure. GLT? And then the Rock-O-Rito. But then there's the burger platter, too, so I don't know.
That is tough. I think I like them all, to be honest. It really depends on, like what's going on. Like. You know, or price-wise, if they have something for sale, you know what I mean? You gotta order that. I mean, I would like to come back here a lot and literally try everything and see what really just blows me away, because all of that, I don't have any complaints about that. Not one. Everything was a very new experience for me, too.
And I love that, because it's beautiful to be able to share. I know, right? I love sharing my places with people and seeing, getting the joy out of someone else enjoying it as much as I do.
We're not looking at that because it was on the table.
Gotcha.
Did you let him go?
Only if you're ready. I mean, I can read comments all day.
Let's wrap it up. I'm probably going to go live when I get back to the What Love Shack. Are you going to go live tonight? Maybe. But thank you so much for joining us today. Did you have fun? Yeah. You want to say anything before we go? She's eating. If you guys like this, please share it, okay? Because we're going to be doing this anyways, but if you guys like super, super like it, we'll do it once or twice a week, at least once a week. And we'll go all over. And we'll probably come back here a lot. But let us know in the comments section. And she's got a mouthful of food. And I got the burpees.
He'll burp and I'll pick up after that. So, remember we have the Rad Juicer giveaway. If you're interested in winning that Rad Juicer, all you have to do is start adding all your friends, 200 or more. You'll be entered. Even if you already have one, we can send it somewhere else to someone else that you choose. We're all about spreading the love. You know that's the whole point of this group, is this is your playground. Get your rad self over there. If you haven't introduced yourself, get in the group. Let us get to know you. Go live. We really love to see and hear you. It's so much more personable. And you know what? It's exercising that courage muscle for a lot of you. And those of you who've already done it, you can also share with those who may be apprehensive about hitting that live button. It gets addictive, doesn't it? You want to go live because it feels good. Right?
That's right.
We love you all from the bottom of our hearts.
Keep it raw.
Stay rad. What?
Hi, y'all.